Good morning, America. Good morning, world. Hello, this is NASCAR.com GarageCam. Well, it's Xfinity Series GarageCam presented by Mobile One, live here on NASCAR.com. I'm your host, Matthew Dillner, bringing you behind the scenes, all access, including double duty, Chris Fontaine. He'll be splitting his time between this number 99 car and the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series, which he normally does well on these plate tracks. Scott Lagacy also pulling double duty. He wrecked yesterday in practice in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series. Kyle Larson pulling double duty. He'll be in his cup car. And also in this Ineos number 42. Hello, everybody. If you're new to the chat, if you're new to NASCAR.com GarageCam, if you're a first-timer, which, Tigra, I know you're not a first-timer. You were the first in the chat room. Pole position, first in the interactive garage. Boom, score, mark it down, Tigra, for the win. If you're new to it, though, or even if you're not new to it, okay, you see this video here of Joe Niemicek's car. It used to be the chat room was on the right, okay, and I'm so used to saying that. But you see up to the top left corner, there's a little chat bubble, like a little talk bubble. Click on that, it opens up the chat, and now you can move the chat wherever you want if you're watching live. If you're watching on replay, come on, man, hook it up, watch live. This is awesome, this is your show. Anyway, Joe Niemicek, let's get back to the business because we got a lot of race cars to show you today. Will Yeager here, my audio guy, CJ Letirso, the man who needs a Twitter. We're rocking it out here in the garage area right now, and we're going to take your request. Joe Niemicek, I know there'll be plenty of requests for front row Joe. That's because he sat on the front row here before. And also, Joe Niemicek, good little stat for you stat nerds right there. Joe Niemicek, the only two-time winner in this field here at Daytona. Two NASCAR Xfinity Series wins for this driver right here. His son, of course, making his debut this weekend, John Hunter Niemicek, in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series, his debut at Daytona. Bobby Gerhart, the number 85 machine, he's got a lot of wins here at Daytona in the ARCA Series, and he's going to be pulling double duty as well, driving in the Camping World Truck Series. A lot of double dippers this weekend. Mario Gosselin, Super Mario, back in the number 92. A lot of cars trying to make this field here for Saturday's race, the NASCAR Xfinity Series, part of an amazing weekend here at Daytona International Speedway. And of course, how can we not mention Daytona Rising? We went up and as a group and sat up in the stands watching the ARCA race, and I'll tell you what, it was absolutely spectacular. It's Kirby. NASCAR, follow at NASCAR, follow at Xfinity Racing, one of the best Twitter accounts you'll see. And it's all because of them. Anyway, NASCAR is so social. We love social media. Hashtag NASCAR, hashtag GarageCam, baby. If you want to tweet with me between shows, kick it. We like it. Here's the number 17 right here, Jeff Green, former series champion. Jeff Green. Owensboro, Kentucky. Oh, speaking of Owensboro, Kentucky. You're playing on your phone. What are you doing on your phone today, Jeff Green?
We got a slot car track back in White House, Tennessee, and I was ordering some parts. So.
Oh.
Yeah, during the week we race slot cars.
So you race slot cars, and all the other greens race RC cars. What's the deal? You like being on a rail?
Yeah, I like being on a rail, that's for sure.
You'd like to be on a rail here in this car, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that's true. They opened up a slot car track there, and we raced slot cars when I lived in North Carolina, so I was able to get my stuff back out and just have a lot of fun with a lot of guys that I've raced with over the years, and we can lean on each other a little bit harder, you know, on a slot car. But wish to live in North Carolina. I would race RC cars with Tyler and Mark and those guys. They look like they're having a lot of fun. But
okay, if you're on a track here, on a rail, if you're on a rail here in your number 17 out in Daytona, which rail do you want to be on? The left rail, the bottom rail, the middle rail, or the high side here within the closing laps?
I just like to be on one, to tell you the truth. So, you know, I don't know. Whichever one looks like the outside from the cup cars are where to be, but it all depends who you're with, who's behind you and who's in front of you, and we'll try to do our best job here with this dash hub car, and hopefully we'll be in the position where we can have a good finish come Saturday.
All right, there it is, the dash hub car, and Jeff Green, Owensboro, Kentucky. Thanks a lot for joining us, of course. Jeff Green, former series champion, and what a heck of a nice guy. Here is the Chevrolet Camaro number 5 of Casey Kane. One of only a handful of winners here at this track that are in this field. Only five drivers in this garage right now that have won in the NASCAR XFINITY Series here, in Casey Kane and this Hellman's Croker machine, one of them. Oh boy, we gotta love seeing this car in the garage area. The day that I don't see the number 89 is a day that I get a little sad. That'll be a sad day. But there is Morgan Shepherd's number 89, Courtney Construction Chevrolet. 74 years old, Morgan Shepherd. I think it was 1977 the first time that Morgan Shepherd came here to compete in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series race, actually. Didn't qualify, came back the next year in 78, put it in the show in a Jim May car, Mercury. What's up, Josh? How you doing? It's been a couple months. We're going to see you behind the wheel here soon, or what?
Yeah, hopefully next week at Atlanta. So I didn't have a ride here, so I'm here helping out Derek. And
so a lot of people don't realize, okay, you not only race, but you do pretty much about everything.
Yeah, I've learned over the years I can do a lot of the different stuff. So I'm very fortunate for all the opportunities I've gotten to be in this garage area and get to function in a lot of different roles. So I'm very grateful. But yeah, if I'm not behind a wheel of a car, I still love motorsports. So I like coming down and helping out too.
Hey, it's kind of like a utility player in baseball. You can play all positions. There it is, Josh Rayum, helping out this number 40. Derek White, hardworking kid right there. Getting to know him a little bit. Anthony Coopin, the former NASCAR Euro Series champion in our garage area right now. It's great to see NASCAR's different touring series out there. Now, moving up some of these drivers. Moving up through those ranks, whether it's the NASCAR Mexico Series and Daniel Suarez, or the NASCAR Whelen Modified Tour with drivers like Ryan Preece making his debut. We'll probably see his car in a little bit. But Anthony Coopin, a really nice guy right here and a very marketable race car driver, hoping that he has some success in this series. It would be great to get that international flair here in the sport of NASCAR. Is this a hard garage to motor through though? This is no gimme over here in NASCAR. Derek Coke could tell you that, former winner of the Daytona 500. The Harmonator right next door, Mike Harmon. It's a little more early in the morning. We had a late night last night, so some of the guys that were here for the Cup race are a little groggy. Stanton Barrett, stunt driver, hoping not to pull any stunts this weekend. Veteran NASCAR racer. Mark Thompson, veteran of the ARCA series, making a NASCAR Xfinity Series start here. Eric Amarola driving a Biaggi Dembesti number 98. Fresh from Florida. Oh yeah, on the hood of that Ford Mustang. Matt Tift back in our garage area. So Matt Tift making several NASCAR Camping World Truck Series starts in 2015. Oh, we still got more to go. What am I doing? I'm about to cut through the garage area and jip you guys out of seeing some great race cars, including all these new paint schemes. You gotta love it. Eric McClure, Reynolds Wrap. This year it'll be on the number 0 Johnny Davis entry for Eric McClure. Vroom Brands on the side of this Harrison Rhodes number 97. All these new cars, you got to keep a roster. You got to cut a pen and paper. Watch GarageCam. We'll show you all the new paint schemes every week. We show you them on Paint Scheme Preview as well on NASCAR.com. We always love to put up those galleries with the new paint schemes. So keep it logged on to NASCAR.com. Joey Gase, the number 52. Of course, this car owned by racing legend Jimmy Means. Martin Roy in the number 90. Ray Black, it's a little low key here in the garage this morning. Things are starting to fire up. By the time we get to the second side of that garage, we should start to see some drivers. So we'll take some of your requests. We'll take some shout outs here. I know Hans Rons said, oh man, good morning, race fans. Yes, good morning, race fans. Gotta love Aaron Summers. I'm so glad that NASCAR is back. Hey, guess what? That makes two of us. Donald Corbin. Morning, guys. Ready for some more NASCAR. Woo! This is the final NASCAR.com Garage Cam of Speed Weeks as we pass Ray Black's number 07 here. We had two Cup shows, a NASCAR Camping World Truck Series show, and of course this NASCAR Xfinity Series show. So a lot of new things in the NASCAR Xfinity Series this year. A lot of new hype, a lot of big talk right now because of this chase format. Can a full-time team, maybe an underfunded team, squeak out a win, get in on points, and make themselves a contender in that chase? It's going to be an interesting year for the NASCAR Xfinity Series regulars here in 2016. Benny Gordon, the number 14 TriStar Motorsports entry. Man, that number 14 looks like Hughes Motorsports modified, if you follow the NASCAR Southern Wheel & Modified Tour. Same exact number. Gotta love it. Maybe they're a big Bobby Meesmer fan. John West Townley pulling triple duty this weekend. There is JWT's 05. He opened up the show for us yesterday on NASCAR Camping World Truck Series Garage Cam. And check it out. Look who we got right here. Look who we got right here. It's Blake Cook. All right, man. New team, new outlook.
Yeah, man. New team, new manufacturer, but same sponsor, same filter gutter protection. With Pollock Racing now, we drive Chevys, and I'm about to go do what I've been wanting to do for 2.5 months, and that's driving race cars.
Yeah, it's hard to sit around and wait, but this season is going to be a different season for you. It's been such a learning curve for you here in the series. This year is going to be about progression.
Being with a really good team makes things a lot more fun. Everybody's working together really good, but I'm really looking forward to putting together everything I've learned over the last 6 years in the series to this year. And I'm excited about the chase format. That's pretty cool. Gives you something to look forward to, being top 12 when you get to Kentucky, and then staying in the chase, and then, I mean, winning the dang championship. That'd be awesome.
Blake Cook right here, leaf filter gutter protection machine. Oh, it's loud in our garage area. That's the way we like it. Turn up those speakers and enjoy you some right there. Some NASCAR in your living room, wherever you're watching it, in your basement, in your bathroom, at work. I don't care. Anyway, the 01 Johnny Davis entry, we got to talk about this car here because that's a pretty cool opportunity for Ryan Preece to be running full-time. Your 2013 NASCAR Wheel & Modified Series, Wheel & Modified Tour champion right there. And NASCAR Next program, he was a NASCAR Next competitor. A very strong young talent in our sport. Look out for Berlin, Connecticut's Ryan Preece. I'm sure we'll talk to him a bunch in Garage Cam this year as well. See if we can catch up with David Starr over here. I see David Starr. Hey, Rayanne! Big Garage Cam fan right there, Rayanne. And now here is David Starr live on NASCAR.com Garage Cam. All right, Starr, we were hanging out watching some practice the other day, talking, and we were talking about the great opportunity that you have here at Daytona because this is a place that you really seem to run well at.
Well, man, I love it. It's just everybody's exciting to start the season. A lot of great things going on. You know, all the drivers are excited. The sponsors are excited. Man, us at TriStar, got a new crew chief, got a lot of new guys on our team. I have Zachary Goop back with us this year. And man, NASCAR's done a great job, and just our whole industry with the Chase being in the NASCAR Xfinity Series and in the Truck Series. A lot of great things going on. I'm just excited to be here. Glad it's still racing. Man, that burning desire to win and to run good still burns so hot inside of me. So, man, I just can't wait. I'm looking forward to practice getting started, and it's going to be a great race, I can tell you that.
I know you got to focus on the race car, and you got to focus on the task at hand. Have you ever at night pictured yourself holding that trophy here at Daytona?
Man, every time I come through that tunnel, you know, down there coming off turn four, you come through that tunnel, I had to pinch myself to make sure it's really happening because, man, the first time I ever came through that tunnel, and then coming through the tunnel this morning, man, just, you just can't believe it. It's awesome, you know, and to be able to win at Daytona, everybody dreams about it. It's the ultimate. If there's one race you just like a dream of winning, it would be at Daytona. We come so close so many times, and just love it that I have the opportunity to race here. And do I dream about winning at Daytona? You dang right I do. I can't, I dream about it all the time. But it's tough. It's a tough series, Any NASCAR series is tough, and it'll be a tough race again Saturday afternoon. But our Zachary Toyota Camry and Frank Carr will be ready for the task. But I'm ready. Just excited.
Thanks for joining us on NASCAR.com. Oh, halfway, says Flagman. The bearded Flagman today says halfway. I don't think we've seen a Flagman in motorsports with that epic of a beard. Jaeger. Oh, rocking it, son. Can we squeak through here, guys? Am I too thick? No, I'm not. We're doing it. Come on. Let's brighten you up so you can see inside the garage here. We cut through the number 44 garage stall. Hands full. All hands on deck here for all these crews. Working hard here to get their car ready for the first practice of 2016 for the NASCAR XFINITY Series. Ross Chastain, the number 4, the Watermelon Kid right there. Give you a look at that Johnny Davis entry. The third Johnny Davis entry. Tigra, hey, my band name is on the deck lid at the very bottom. Tigra's tirade on this car right here. That's right. I got to apologize to Jeremy. I was going to put my name on it, and I forgot to. We're going to have to do it, this promotion again, Jeremy Clements. But let's see, where's Tigger's band name? Guys, can you help me find it? A bunch of names right here. These are people that supported a little program here to ride with Jeremy Clements on the car. We're looking for it. There it is. TiggersTirade.com/music. Oh, yeah. On your name, GarageCam fan Tigger, your name is on the back of the number 50. Oh, whoa, who's this guy? Oh, it's security. Security has entered the building for the number 51 ride. Tell us about your deck lid, man.
We got a bunch of names on there, man. Where's your name?
I was supposed to put one on there. I think I messaged you and said, hey, I'll do it. I totally forgot, dude. I got a baby. Like, all I'm thinking about is diapers.
Give me $10.
I don't have my wallet on you, but this guy's got plenty of money.
Hey, you guys give me $10 each, I'll sharpie you on there. How about that?
Yeah, I
nice hat, by the way.
What am I wearing?
I don't even know what that's called.
Oh, yeah, it's the blue one. I think you look better with
that. You don't have your those vintage hats you usually wear,
No, this is my usual hat.
Yeah, but it blocks the sun.
It does a little bit. It's plus, nice. You look kind of like a taxi driver or a newsboy.
How
I'm not sure.
Do I look?
You actually look pretty good. Right now, I think NASCAR would really get on board with a different look for Jeremy Clements.
If that's what it takes, we'll make it happen.
Make it happen. Well, tell us about this 51 because it's really good to see it with so much sponsorship on board. I'm sure you guys worked really hard in the off season. For this race here in Daytona.
Yeah, we got 92.5 WESC on the roof and the TV panel. It's a country station upstate. And then we got Kevin Whitaker Chevrolet on board for this race. And RepairableVehicles.com as always. So just want to thank all them for coming on board for this race. And hopefully we can win this thing. Oh, yeah, Rob Inario. I'm sorry.
Oh, you forgot about Rob.
Yeah,
I mean, local, poor Rob.
Local attorney in Greenville. When a good time goes bad.
Hey, I think this guy looks a lot better than me right now.
I look stupid.
My damn hat head sucks right now, dude.
I look ridiculous.
No, wow, you look great. Awful. Look at this guy. He's awesome.
It's rough looking.
All right, buddy. We'll see you on GarageCam throughout the year. I want my hat back.
I'm keeping it.
I do. No, sideways. You look like Blossom or something from that 80s show.
Hey, thanks for coming and seeing me. Hey, there's David Starr. You want to talk to David Starr?
Oh, we've talked to David Starr.
Oh, I see you, David.
Yeah. Hey, what do you think about this guy right here, this Jeremy
Clements
guy?
This is awesome, dude. This guy right here is a great guy.
He's lying. I had to pay him $100 for that.
When they dropped a green flag, we're at war, but after the checker flag drops, we're great friends.
That's right. Yeah. He buys beer all the time.
Hey, I want to get in on that program. Yeah. All right.
See you guys.
Well, you see the names on the side of the car and on the deck lid. That's awesome there, Jeremy Clements. One of the great young personalities in our sport. And, hey, speaking of young personalities right here, I like this kid. You know why? He's got those southern roots right there, just like Jeremy Clements. Jeb Burton's got that little slow, low accent. I kind of like it right there. But what a great opportunity for Jeb Burton right now, racing in this number 43 car this year. And you know what? I think we see him, our spotter right here. has picked up on Jeb Burton. All right, Jeb, man, cool deal for you this year, man. In 2016, kind of came together late, and great opportunity for you.
Yes, sir. Looking forward to getting on the track and the Jay Stryker Rocky Ridge Ford for Rich Petty Motorsports. So I'm excited to be here. I feel like this is probably my best opportunity. I got a bunch of good people around me. I got a great crew chief and Drew Blickenstover, so yep. I'm ready to go, and hopefully this thing's fast.
Hey, how cool is it, man? We've grown up in the sport. Okay, I remember you when you're knee-high or a grasshopper, but how cool is it to be affiliated with the king?
It's very cool, especially to drive the number. He approved me driving that number. He feels like we can go win and make him proud. So I'm just excited to be here and be with part of the king and their legacy. So got some good things working, and hopefully we can go put this baby up front.
All right, Jeb Burton driving that number 43 Mustang right there, Richard Petty Motorsports. Run alongside right here, Coder Armstrong. He drove this 43 last season in a Toyota Camry this year. Ryan Sieg, the number 39, rocking out here in the garage. Need some sponsorship on that car, so good young race car driver right there. Brendan Poole walking out of his garage area. BJ McLeod, always got some really colorful looking cars, does BJ McLeod. Brendan Poole, the Bull. Just walked out of his garage area, driving the number 48 this year. Ineos and DC Solar on board this Ganassi entry. Oh boy, this guy's got his helmet on already. Folks, it's BG Brendan Gaughan strapping on the helmet. This guy's excited for practice. Hey, where's your sunglasses?
My sunglasses? I left them in a bathroom somewhere. Some guy started like peeing on them or something, so I had to get rid of them.
Oh, so all right, man. Back to brass tacks here. This is such a great opportunity for you guys this year. Daytona's Daytona, man. The season's the season. But, you know, Brendan Gaughan right here, he's got this real legitimate shot at something called a championship this year.
No, you know, we always start the year thinking we have a shot at it. We've had speed to do it. But we have a couple races that just kill you in points. Now, those races don't kill you anymore, so this is going to be awesome. The new chase format, really excited about that. You know, the new dash for cash deal. We'll see. You know, I'm not going to start telling you it's great until we see what it looks like. But I know the chase format, and that's a great deal for not only our sport, but for the fans and the drivers. It's going to be awesome.
All right, Brendan Gaughan in this number 62, taking time to talk to us and you guys, the NASCAR race fans. While he's strapping into the car, you got to appreciate that right there. Austin Dillon, another one of the five drivers in this field that have won here at Daytona in the NASCAR XFINITY Series, making another start here. And I got to tell you, the cowl. Here, let me look at that request there. But the cowl on this thing, cowl cover is pretty darn cool right there with the horns. You got to love it on Austin Dillon's car. Luis DiDonato, you want to see the number 88. Of Chase Elliott, and this is your Daytona 500 pole sitter right here, and he's strapping in his car, getting ready in the Junior Motorsports number 88. TaxSlayer.com on the hood of that car. We still have a few cars to show you and some really cool new paint schemes, so we're going to motor along here because we don't want to miss them. Chris Cockrum rolling in the car, number 25. Bubba Wallace, fresh off his Fruit Loops this morning. That he tweeted us in this Selfio Mustang. Daniel Suarez, last year's star rookie of this series, the Mexico native in the Aris number 18. And hey, how about these new digs right here? Got new digs on this driver right here. The Brandt number 7, Junior Motorsports, and that's Justin Allgaier. What's up, Gator? You already got a Gator this week, winning in your dirt car, and now here at the big track, focus shifts.
It does focus shifts, but I think it's the same goal. You know, obviously, even though the trophy's a little bit different than that little Gator we won at the dirt track, still, we're always going for the trophy, always having fun. It's always good to be back to Daytona. I think, you know, you get to the end of the season, and you're ready for the year to be over, and then you hit the reset button about Christmas time, you're ready to go back to the track, and you get to Daytona, and it's like, all right, we're finally here. We're finally ready to go. And
let's do this.
We've got some fun. I mean, we got a great team behind us. Everybody here at Junior Motorsports has done a great job this offseason. And glad to be back in the old familiar Brent Freshman Agriculture colors. It's going to be a good year. I'm excited. I'm pumped up.
All right, this driver right here, expect some big things out of Justin Allgaier and this Brandt machine. Going for wins, new chase format should be pretty cool for guys like this to chase in the Xfinity Series. And Justin Allgaier, a talented race car driver, he's won here in this series before. He could get it done. Ty Dillon, the number three, red number three, Bass Pro Shops scheme. Most of the drivers getting to their cars right now. We're going to roll through here so we can make sure we show you everybody. Here's a new paint scheme for you. The number one, the one main financial Chevrolet Camaro. That's because it's Junior Motorsports this year for Elliott Sadler. Camaro looking sporty. And here's a guy that's going to be a story this year. And you can mark that down right now. Young Eric Jones, NASCAR Camping World Truck Series champion. This will be his first full season in the NASCAR Xfinity Series as he straps on the helmet right here. The Michigan native in the number 20 for Joe Gibbs Racing. Expect some W's out of this car. Expect some noise from that young Michigan driver this season. Already has a NASCAR Xfinity Series win to his credit. Got that first win last year at Texas Motor Speedway. Brandon Jones, the number 33, driving an RCR machine. Talented young race car driver. Going to be getting a lot of seat time this year here in the series and in the truck series. We got to skip over. We're going to skip over Ryan Reed here because if we don't show this number 18, we're cheating you guys, the fans, because it's so cool that Joe Gibbs Racing and their anniversary season is bringing back this driver for this race. But Bobby Labonte in the number 18 car, and what a treat this is to see old Bobby Labonte back in a Joe Gibbs Racing car. The number 18, the number 22, Joe Logano. Off the garage area, and so is Bobby Labonte's slick-looking number 18. Practice session about to be underway. Bubba Wallace about to roll by in the number 6 purple car. Yeah, oh man, you can't miss that car when it's on track. Speaking of can't miss cars, you can't miss the Brandt number 7 right there of Justin Allgaier. Here comes your favorite driver, Rianne. We saw you before. Brendan Gaughan in the number 62. Driver Ryan Reed. Still in his garage area, strapping in. He's pulling double duty. He's racing over there in the NASCAR Camping World Truck Series, but last year's winner in the NASCAR Xfinity Series here at Daytona. A Cinderella story indeed. Youth gone wild right here in this garage. They're running rampant. The young race car driver movement in the Camping World Truck Series and here. Oh boy, it's something else. And when you got guys like Eric Jones and Brandon Jones right alongside each other in the garage area, you just know that this garage area is full of some immense talent and great equipment here in the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Such a great year. This is going to be a milestone year for this series. So much to look forward to this year. So many people, Krista Burrell, Hans Rons, Aaron Summers, oh, Louis DiDonato, we love hearing from you in the garage area. It's kind of quiet right now. Not all the cars have rolled out of their stalls, but most of them have. Got about a minute and a half before practice starts. Been here for quite a few years now running this series. 1982, Dale Earnhardt winning the first race here for the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Seven-time winner, him and Smoke. The guys with 7 wins here. What's up, Stanton Barrett? Walking by. Him and Smoke on top of the list as far as 7 wins are concerned. Dale Earnhardt Jr., I believe, has 6. But the leading active driver, Joe Nemechek, with 2. Lots of new faces, lots of new names, lots of new paint schemes here in the NASCAR Xfinity Series. Make sure you check out a few things on NASCAR.com. Tech Talk, our new segment. Dude, I like this. I'm a gearhead. I love it. Jonathan Merriman getting it done, talking about NASCAR's new digital dash. Make sure you check out that video on NASCAR.com. Oh, another big thing coming up. February 27th, 100,000 cams. That's right, 100,000 cameras. Hashtag 100K cams. And hashtag NASCAR. Oh, they're doing it for the Daytona 500. So if you're a race fan, take your video, make sure you take it horizontal send it in to Twitter or different social media using hashtag 100KCams. That's going to air on February 27th. I'm going to set my DVR to check that out. The Daytona 499 is another thing that you got to look out for. This week on NASCAR.com, one of the coolest features I've seen in a long time. I'm not going to tell you what it is, but you need to look out for it. I promise you. And of course, the Dirty Air Podcast and all our great videos on NASCAR.com. I'm not trying to sound like a commercial, but man, we try hard here at this website, and we do it all for you guys. Speaking of that, this is your show. Go get you some coffee. Go get you a sandwich, maybe. Tune on the TV and make sure you tune in to NASCAR.com all weekend long. And hey, flip it on over to FS1 tomorrow, 3:30 p.m. for the Power Shares Triple Q 300 on FS1, MRN, and Sirius XM Satellite Radio from the World Center of Racing. I'm your host, Matthew Dillner. Until next time, we'll see you at the races.